children, today we are going to learn lesson number 5, division. You must have learned division in a small part in standard 2. Let us take division more forward. Now, what is division, children? Division means equal sharing. When we share the things equally. Okay. When we are sharing the things equally, we are dividing. Okay. Suppose we will take here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Suppose these are 8 laddus. We are going to group them into 2. So we will make the groups. 1 group, 2 group, 3 group, and 4 groups. Okay, we are doing equal sharing here. So, in simple way, equal sharing means division. So, when we share the things equally amongst our friends, we say that we are dividing. So, which is the symbol for division, children? Symbol for division is a horizontal line, a dot on the top, and a dot down. This is the symbol of division. Children, here division also means repeated subtraction. How do we share? We share by giving the things. And when we are giving the things, we are subtracting it. Suppose we are taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 laddus. Okay? And we are to make a group of 3. Okay, let's take the first laddu, put it here, second one here, one more here. So we are doing the equal sharing. What are we doing, children? We are subtracting the number. One by one, we are subtracting the number. Cancel this, put it here, cancel this, put it here. Okay, similarly here, here, and here. So what we have done? We have subtracted again and again the same number. Repeated subtraction is called as division. Repeated addition is called as multiplication. Let us take the first example, children. Let us count the balls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So, in total, we are having 18 balls. Now, if you can see, I have a division problem here. 18 balls divided by 3 children. Okay? Divided amongst 3 children. How much balls each child gets? Okay? So, let us see. What did I say? Division is repeated addition, repeated subtraction. Sorry, children. So, divided by 3. So, we have to take repeated subtraction minus 3. 18 minus 3. This is the one group. Okay. One more time. Second group. Third group. Fourth group. Fifth group. And sixth group. Okay. So, first time we gave one balls to each one. Then again we gave. Again we gave. Again. Again and again. So, how many times each one of them got? So, if you can see the lines, there are 6 lines. It means we have subtracted 3, 6 times. So, we can write here, 18 divided by 3 equals to 6. Each child gets 6 balls. Okay? Let us take the second example. 18 divided by 6. Now, this time we are going to take 6 balls at a time. So this one time, suppose we took this one time, let us take this and this 3, we can continue with this. Okay, so how many times we have taken 6? One time, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many times? 3 times. 18 divided by 6 equals to 3. So, if we have 6 children, each child gets 3 balls. Understood, children?